quite possibly the most dynamic diva in show business. She's the reigning queen of rock and soul, and she's a survivor with a heart as big as her voice. She shares her pearls of wisdom in her new powerful album called Gems. Please welcome Grammy Award winner Patti LaBelle.
Yes!
I look fierce.
What do you mean you look fierce?
I'm dressed when I go out. You'll never catch me in a jogging suit or sneakers.
Oh, no, see, what a hassle.
Oh, no, it's not. I wake up that way. Just like this
really?
Morning.
Let me tell you something.
You have to wake up fierce, honey, or don't wake up at all.
Patti LaBelle, referred to by many as the godmother of soul, has released 17 solo albums and over 10 albums as a member of the musical group LaBelle. She has won 2 Grammys and was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame and won an American Music Award in 1993. Even with recognizable hits such as Feels Like Another One and If Only You Knew, You Are My Friend, and her stirring rendition of Over the Rainbow, success comparable to her contemporaries like Aretha Franklin or Gladys Knight on the pop charts did not come until LaBelle, born Patricia Hault, was in her early 40s. This begs the question, why did Patti LaBelle not get her flowers earlier in her career? And what made her rise to stardom so akin to that of a butterfly in bloom? Patricia Hault was born in 1944 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the 4th of 5 children. Despite growing up with parents in an abusive relationship, she won a singing competition at her high school, which led to the formation of a musical group named the Ordettes. Following both a lineup change and a name change, the Bluebells found success with the single I Sold My Heart to the Junkman in 1963. Patti LaBelle and the Bluebells found further success with singles such as Down the Aisle, You'll Never Walk Alone, and Danny Boy. After moving to Atlantic Records, the Bluebells found success with singles like All or Nothing, Take Me for a Little While, Over the Rainbow, and Groovy Kind of Love. In 1970, the Bluebells were dropped from Atlantic Records, and after gaining the attention of television producer Vicki Wickham, underwent a dramatic wardrobe and musical change. After signing with Track Records, LaBelle released a self-titled LP in 1971. The effort was described as melodramatic and poorly written, but it marked the beginning of a fusion of psychedelic, rock, and R&B, which the trio would become synonymous with. Following the release of 2 more albums, in 1974, LaBelle released Nightbirds, and it spawned the hit single Lady Marmalade, which peaked at number 1 on the pop charts. The success of the single landed the group on the cover of Rolling Stone magazine. They released 2 more albums, Phoenix and Shyamalan, both of which charted on the pop and R&B charts. The group separated following conflict over its musical direction, and soon thereafter, Patti LaBelle signed a solo contract with Epic Records. Her first album, eponymously titled Patti LaBelle, was released in 1977 and featured the singles Joy to Have Your Love and You Are My Friend. The album was described as outstanding in a 1977 Rolling Stone review. She released 3 more albums, Tasty, It's All Right With Me, and Released, all of which were well received critically but failed to garner LaBelle a hit. Her first LP on Philadelphia International Record, The Spirits In It, featured a cover of Over the Rainbow. But it was her next album which gave her her first taste of success. Her second Philadelphia International LP, I'm In Love, was her most successful release up to then. The first single for the album, If Only You Knew, garnered LaBelle her first solo R&B hit. It reached number 46 on the pop charts, and her second single from the album, Love, Need, and Want You, peaked at number 10 on the R&B charts. In December 1984, MCA released New Attitude from the soundtrack of the film Beverly Hills Cop, starring Eddie Murphy. It continued the streak, started with If Only You Knew, and peaked at number 17 on the pop charts and 3 on the R&B. The next single from the Beverly Hills Cop soundtrack, Stir It Up, peaked at number 5 on the R&B charts. After a label change, LaBelle released Winner in You in 1986, which was anchored by the single On My Own, a duet with Michael McDonald, which peaked at number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100. The success of On My Own and New Attitude gave Patti LaBelle the fame that had once eluded her. but why did it take so long to reach her? A major reason for LaBelle's late success is the climate during which she was a member of Patti LaBelle and the Bluebells. During the mid to late 60s, the most successful girl group in the United States was the Supremes. The Supremes served as a launching pad of sorts for Diana Ross's solo career, a career which I discussed in my previous video. But their success was not due to their superiority over the Bluebells, but due to the fact that they had the backing of a record company invested in their success, something that the Bluebells lacked. When Patti LaBelle and the Bluebells began their tenure with Atlantic Records after Cameo Parkway folded, another young artist signed with the label. Aretha Franklin. Attention that originally would have been given to the Bluebells' music and promotional efforts shifted to Aretha Franklin, and although the Bluebells did release two albums, Over the Rainbow and Dreamer, in 1966 and 67, they were completely overshadowed by Aretha Franklin's two releases in 1967, despite both the Bluebells' albums being spotlighted in two issues of Billboard from 1966 and 1967 respectively, with the former being described as excellent and great, and the latter being described as a showcase of one of the outstanding female groups in the music business. This explains the dynamics at play when at the 1993 and 95 Essence Awards, Patti LaBelle performed Ain't No Way and Ain't No Mountain High Enough during tributes to Aretha Franklin and Diana Ross, respectively, a task usually given to a newer artist rather than a contemporary of both Franklin and Ross's. Additionally, in an October 1966 issue of Billboard magazine, a single from Dreamer, I'm Still Waiting, peaked at number 38 on the R&B charts, while the number 1, 2, 3, and 4 spot on that same chart were occupied by singles released by Motown artists, including the Supremes. Not only were the gains made by Patti LaBelle overshadowed by her own label mate, Aretha Franklin, but they were too overshadowed by those made by an entire record label. While the Supremes were America's ladies, Patti LaBelle and the Bluebells were ladies of the Apollo. Even with their image and music change in 1970, which was described in a 1976 issue of Ebony magazine as a metamorphosis of sound, light, and energy, which resulted in LaBelle becoming the first black female group to grace the cover of Rolling Stone magazine and perform at the New York Met, they still had yet to attain the consistent success that came with having crossover appeal, and that carried over into Patti LaBelle's solo career. Another factor that may have contributed to Patti finding success in the later stages of her career, she has a 3-octave range and is a dramatic soprano. Songwriters, especially in the early stages of her career with the Bluebells, most likely did not know how to write or produce for such a striking voice. It was not until she signed with Philadelphia International Records that Kenny Gamble gave LaBelle material that both suited and utilized her full range of voice. And a greater example of this comes from listening to Patti LaBelle and her Bluebells on the 1966 rendition of Over the Rainbow on Atlantic Records, compared to her 1981 rendition on Philadelphia International Records. Oh,
By the mid-70s, Patti LaBelle knew it was time to sing solo. But after 7 years and 8 albums, she still had no consistent following.
I can't always blame the promotion guy or the record company. It could have been my choice of material or the way I sang it. Maybe I wasn't pleasing that many people. I'll take some of the weight.
Despite not getting recognized until she was well into her 40s and in the second decade of her career, which had crossed genres and continents, Patti LaBelle is now considered one of the best female vocalists ever and has amassed a fortune as a businesswoman, with her own line of food being sold in Walmart stores.